Suppose I'm planning a surprise birthday party and want to ask friends if they can come. Let's use a Google form. When you first create a form, you can choose a name and a theme for your form. I'll go with the balloon theme for this. This here is the form editor. We've got a title already, and here we can add a description to the form. Below, we can work on what questions to ask. So, question 1. Can you come to the party next Saturday? If you need to clarify a question, you can add descriptive text here, but I think this question's simple enough. Then, down here, choose a question type. There are a few different options to choose from. I won't go over all of them now, but you should play around with them sometime. Let's choose multiple choice. When you're done with the question, click Done. All right, question 2. To add it, click the Add Item button here. And let's ask, what kind of cake should we get? There are lots of different kinds of cake, so we'll make this a text question and let respondents write in their answer here. Click Done, and I've made my second question. You can, of course, add as many questions as you'd like. Now I want to share this form with a friend of mine who's helping to plan the party to make sure I haven't left anything out. To do that, I click File, then Share. If you've used Google Drive before, this should look familiar. From here, I can add my friend Susan. Great. Now, if Susan makes changes to this form, I'll see those changes appear in real time. It looks like she's added a question about ice cream and put it above the question about cake. Cool. Then, to see what this form will look like to our friends, we can click the View Live Form button up here. Very festive. Now let's send out this form. To do that, we scroll to the bottom of the form to this confirmation page section here. To send the form, we click the blue Send Form button. You can copy this link to distribute to your friends. You can share the form via social media here, or you can specify individual recipients. I'll add Susan just to make sure she has this. Cool. As you can see, now that we've sent our form out, we're asked to choose a destination for responses. We can choose to create a new spreadsheet, we can use an existing spreadsheet, or if we don't want to use a spreadsheet, we can click the Keep Responses Only in Forms button here. If you choose to keep responses in forms, your form's responses will still be saved, and you'll be able to see a useful summary of them. We'll choose to create a new spreadsheet. Now, if we click this View Responses button, we can see a spreadsheet with the responses we've collected so far. Susan must have sent this out to friends because we have a few responses to our form already. Or, if we don't want to view individual responses but would rather get a big picture sense of what people are saying, we can view the summary of responses. To do that, we click the Responses menu, and we choose Summary of Responses. Okay, that completes the tour. Give Google Forms a try, and if you have any questions about anything not covered in this video, you can find an answer in the Google Drive Help Center.